qualify for the Boston Major with ease, so I think a slight edge to EG, but not by that much. NP has definitely proven they're ready to tango.
All right, well, let's see how they do here. Draft underway now. EG opening up with the Naga Timbersaw Band, NP, Batrider, and the Beastmaster. So NP very focused on those map control and kind of tempo setting heroes, and be much more with the farmers and a little bit more with the teamfight specialists. So EG will overall first pick the IO. You know, it's funny because PPD, I remember, God, I guess it was like about a year ago or so, he did an interview where he basically said, like, yeah, we don't pick IO. But this is a different EG. It's a new day for the team with both Zai and Crit now joining the roster and over the last, I guess, 6 to 9 months or so. So they first pick the IO. NP replies with the Invoker Sven, and then they grab the Drow. And they grab that Drow pretty early in the first phase. So thoughts on the openings here from both teams?
NP really likes this opening just because EE really values Invoker as a hero that he spams in matchmaking like nonstop. I think he just enjoys the hero and thinks it's strong, and Sven, it was one of the better cores to pair with it. It's a nice stun that you can have do aggressive tri lanes and pair up really easily with the Sunstrike because it's the 2 second stun time, so you get the Sunstrike every single time. The Sven can get more active early on, so allow the Invoker to farm up more early items, and it's just like a good core pairing. And also the Aoi and EE aren't typically known for having the most enormous hero pools, so picking up cores early, it also lets you get your supports later to, once you've seen what their cores are, and try and counter them with those picks.
Yeah, and obviously the Sven pick already ends up being a pretty good matchup versus the Drow in a vacuum with the Warcry, so EG not afraid of that by any means. Now that Sumail Storm is out there that comes to mind is something that goes well with the Drow. Anything in particular you would like to see from EG heading into the second phase? Like, what goes particularly well versus the...
Yeah, like you said, the Storm is a good pick. They actually banned out the Dusa and the Mirana, so looking like they're ready to deal with the Sumail Storm Spirit. I think that's probably a pretty likely pick. Does really well with the Drow. Good against Sven and Invoker reasonably well. Neither of them have, you know, a lot of catch. Sven's stun is reasonably easy to dodge if he doesn't blink and stun you from point blank. Also pretty good versus the Witch Doctor, so I would expect they either maybe third or fourth the Storm Spirit. It's probably Zai playing the Wisp, so as far as Crit goes, maybe looking for an Oracle. Might be a little too save-oriented, though, so... Some hero versus Winter Wyvern doesn't look terrible here. Good versus the Witch Doctor ults, good versus hiding the Sven. They have a lot of right-clickers, good with, like, you know, versus the Invoker and the Sven, obviously. Very right-click-oriented cores, the ult works really well. Good at stalling off pushes. So maybe looking for a Wyvern as well for Crit.
Yeah, and right now, really not that much magic damage on the side of NP. So that Cold Embrace would be very handy and, of course, great for dealing with the Sven. Curious to see what EG do and like how much they want to commit here to try and take those mid-game teamfights, or if they just look for more of that like spread map offense. Because, I mean, you see Drow IO, like it's a little bit of gank, but it's a lot of potential push and sustain as well from the Aura and the Tether, the Overcharge. So I guess it really is open-ended as to which way they want to tackle this. And they do opt for more of that push teamfight route here, grabbing the Warlock. You know, I was pretty much exclusively covering the Asian qualifiers, but Warlock is all the rage in SEA. Like, almost every game, first phase picked or banned, and once in a while will slip through until the second phase. And then in China, he's been a little bit less popular, but still saw some play. How do you feel like Warlock fits into the meta here in America, CCNC, and do you think he's a good matchup in this particular game?
I think a lot of it varies from team to team. Complexity, a team that's known for being very five-man oriented, very team fight, group up early, so the Warlock working well for them. A lot of teams like first banning it versus Complexity. EG not typically known so much for their, you know, we're going to group up super early on, more of like playing tactically, getting pickoffs, and sort of playing the, you know, we'll just outplay you sort of style. EG more typically known for, so, you know, the Warlock, yeah, definitely a good pick here. Nice, the heal, very nice versus the Drow Ranger. The Fatal Bond's always just a ridiculous spell. Phantom and also, assassin. Whenever you do have the Sven Invoker heroes that, once they have a couple of core items, are just going to sort of run at your heroes. It's sort of what their lineup does quite well. Once they've got a couple items online, the Blink on the Sven, the Invoker with, you know, drums on the way to Ags. So the Warlock, a nice counter-initiation tool. And the upheaval also very, very good at kiting Sven before he has BKB up.
Yeah, I remember when Aoi started playing Warlock. Speaking of players in this game, he obviously won't be handling it this time as he is on NP, but he would even max upheaval. I don't know if that's really the build anymore. It seems like everyone goes Fatal Bonds and Shadow Ward, but does have some utility, like you mentioned. So NP picked the PA, and I gotta ask you, CCNC, is this a core or a support PA? Because I just got done seeing Z-Freak play support PA. He went Uv, and he went for the minus armor orb as well, and he had like no regen basically, and just I think he had a mega kill in like 5 minutes. Spirit. So, which are you expecting this game, or do you think it's open ended?
I think it's most probably this the support PA. 1437 plays that quite a bit, and it became really, really popular in NA Plus in the last month or so. You know, like you said, getting the Blightstone and the Oob, and you just sit mid with a Clarity and you throw daggers at them. It's not quite as good anymore because the nerf was the range was nerfed, so you can't sit out of your mid XP and throw the daggers. You have to sort of sap a little bit whenever you walk in for daggers, so not quite as good. But there's a hero like Storm, a hero that really needs a good start and is very prone to getting bullied early. PA is probably just gonna. This mid lane is gonna end up just being a, sort of a dual lane scenario, I think, with the PA throwing lots of daggers and the IO helping the Storm out so he doesn't get too far behind early on.
And obviously, he's gonna have his work cut out for him with the Drow Ranger pick as well, so not gonna be the easiest lane to tackle that Storm, but see what NP can do. Of course, with this pick, they do sacrifice some like mid game catch or team fight potential, so if it is in fact a support, so it does put a lot of pressure on these lanes. For NP to deliver. Heading into the last picks, Tidehunter gets removed by NP. Looks like they're targeting a Universe hero. Unlikely that his has been picked yet. And Eiji are very reliant on the Rock to take team fights in the early to mid game, at least in terms of a head-on clash. So, what Universe hero do you want to see? Is this like a Puck kind of game? I mean, Darkseer's out there, Void is available. What are you thinking?
I think they may lean more towards the Axe. Slaughter, the Nyx. Okay, they go for the Axe. Yeah, I was going to say they want an offlaner with more shorter cooldowns because NP's draft is very much, we'll get some core items, we'll try and do well in our lanes, get, early items up on Sven, and they just sort of run at them, whereas EG has, like, much stronger team fight. The coordinated fights, where things go to plan work much better for EG, so I think the Axe is a really good choice, really good versus Sven, obviously. Blade Mail sort of owning him, and the Invoker as well, pretty good versus whenever you have some higher levels, the right-click damage amping up quite a bit. So I hear with short cooldowns, can go to the jungle and get the blink reasonably early. It'll be interesting to see if the PA goes and sort of tries to mess with him, but Slaughter as well with the PA. The amp dagger is brutal.
Yeah, this is a lot of physical burst and pickoff potential, assuming that they have a decent start here in the lane. So C37 is going to be on the PA, the support Phantom Assassin. Rears its, I won't say ugly head, but its head anyway. And EG definitely get, I think for me, the most probably iconic hero for Sumail on the Storm. I still remember his first big event that I watched him play, which was, I believe, DAC 2015, about a year and a half ago at this point, and it was like he was unfazed. There was one game where he got ganked like 5 times in the mid lane, and they still came back and won, and he had like a 15-minute Bloodstone even after that. So you want to talk about resilience. He certainly showed it there, and I got to imagine he'll be playing it this time around. And of course, along with that, the ever-impressive crit IO. We'll see an early smoke here from EG as the Fountain gets Sunstrike, just a bit of intel. Be looked for. Let me fix my camera sensitivity, but talk to me about these early lanes. You mentioned a bit Phantom Assassin trying to control mid, the IO looking to do the same. What kind of matchups are you expecting to see, and who do you give the edge to win?
I think this top lane should be fine for EG. It's the typical soul offlaner. He'll get what he can. He didn't start the Iron Talon, so he is looking to contest. Maybe keep this Warlock pinned down so the Warlock and the IO can't both rotate to mid and maybe threaten a kill, so they will be pinned up in this top lane, but Arteezy should farm fine. This mid lane, I think it will lean favored. This PA will be able to throw daggers and stuff, but Storm with 6 armor, so not quite as effective versus him as some other mids. And then with the Wisp probably hanging around there as well. Mel just known for being just a really, really good laner, and he, that being probably one of his weaker spots, I would expect mid to lean their way as well. And Universe got the Iron Talon, so bot lane's a no-brainer.
Alright, well, definitely has that plan B available if he wants to retreat back to the jungle, as we will see Sumail immediately moving towards this rune. NP going for the late smoke, and they do have that Sven initiation available, though Crit is just slightly out of range. He moves up and away to the high ground and then tethers back to Arteezy. Looks like he'll make it out, 1437, is able to force them away. And universally, well, if 9 heroes are going to float over that top rune, I will just go ahead and collect the bottom. So, Bounty, he's going to head into lane. MSS alone there for the time being. So, is the PA Witch Doctor Sven offensive tri lane in the end? And this does give the Axe the 1v1 matchup.
Yeah, the Axe starting with the Iron Talon, so not with very much regen. Only the one Tango, or is MSS having the full set of regen, the Mango, the Salve, and the Tango, so should be able to farm fine under his tower. They trade farm, the Axe getting a little bit more, probably because he can farm these hard camps, but yeah, NP really likes to do this with the Sven. They go aggro try on almost every game, they pick it, they can coordinate with the Sunstrikes. But I think it'll open this mid lane up for Sumail to maybe dominate just individual skill-wise, but top lane, it should be okay for EG if they can survive without getting killed. They just have to be wary of getting stunned into the dagger, into the Sunstrike. It's quite a bit of burst damage early on.
Yeah, you look at the mid lane, he's got 70 damage, and that's not even counting the overload. So, putting the last hit war for Eternal Envy at level 1, he only has 50 to work with. Definitely not easy at the start, but Forge Spirit actually sitting at 6-1. Or 5-1, because I jinxed him and he missed that last hit, but doing pretty well, all things considered. Obviously, as the draw levels up, it gets a little trickier, but at the same time, he will get more exhort damage. So, 1437, he does move in with the Blightstone and Orb of Venom, but zero regen to try and contest this pull. Able to fully stop it, as I will let out an early Fatal Bonds, and I guess we're just really waiting on the Sunstrike. So, aside from that, Axe versus Slardar, normally very Axe favored, right? But Universe going for the Iron Talon, it looks like he is dominating this lane so far, though.
Yeah, both heroes will typically farm in most Axe matchups because you just, you know, pull the aggro, and so you push out the wave, and then you go farm the hard camp. So, the Slardar will get most of the CS under tower, but the Axe will just outfarm him because he can farm the hard camp. And eventually, things start getting hairy for the Slardar as Axe hits 5, it sort of swings back the other way when the Slaughter gets to level 6, you can't really play up that much anymore, and it ends up just being a far more most Axe lanes where the Axe can't just bully the person out of the lane, which is the case for Slaughter a lot of times.
Yeah, the bottom lane, MSS is calling for that Sunstrike, it doesn't look like he's getting it. Don't know if it got used elsewhere. Universe, anyway, and MSS ever so low, even turns around for one last hit. Universe! Ooh, threatening, he gets up the Battle Hunger, MSS, not like that. I don't think that was in the anime script, but the Sunstrike, the counter, and it's Universe's turn to feed. Oh man, some avoidable casualties here in the bottom lane, but First Blood does go the way of Universe, and I guess Envy gives him a free heal at the fountain.
Yeah, dying like that is definitely not what you want to do, but he did run out of regen, so trading a whole lot early on. Looks like he tried to punish Universe only having the one Tango, but maybe Universe getting a lot of spins or something, because he was completely out of regen, had to buy another set of Tangos now, so not the worst thing in the world that he died there, because he was able to get more regen at the base instead of having to TP back and then run all the way back down. So Universe does get the first blood, definitely not what you want to have, but not the worst, because he does get a free trip back, so able to have some regen and come back and farm in this lane.
I do want to point out, already EG keeping tabs on the Sven here and any potential ancient stacks as did already ward that area of the map. For now, NP remaining pretty static in the tri-lane. Do you expect to see any support rotations here from either team, CCNC, or are they just going to hold tight and rely on their cores to make the space for them?
At this point, I think it's too late for MP to really make any rotations to mid. Smell's almost level 6, doing extremely well in last hits, almost doubling up EE's CS. Since he is almost 6, he's practically ungankable at this point. The supports may be able to rotate down for the Slaughter, but I expect they'll just let Universe alone, let him do his thing, farm up. They may do the lane switch at some point, bringing the Sven down as his farm is starting to suffer as the draw gets more levels in the Precision Aura. And the Warlock getting more levels in the Shadow Word, so EG's tri lane is going to get progressively stronger as the as they get more levels, whereas NT is sort of, their power spike is very early on in this tri lane with a lot of, you know, the Storm Bolt, the Dagger, spells that don't really scale that amazingly, and Sven a hero that needs some safe farms, so they may end up just doing the lane switch when MSS gets switch 6 and bring the tri lane down to bottom.
Yeah, so that Phantom Assassin did make her way towards mid, 1437, though scouted out by a Dire Ward. They ward wisely here to protect the mid lane, and now Sumail, about one half wave from getting level 6 or so. Gonna move in, at least try to poke a bit, and leech some experience off of Eternal Envy, but no real kill potential, and EG, do see this, so I guess not really the best killing tri lane at this stage, but can play more aggressively anyway in the top lane.
Yeah, their lane just is very good at winning by attrition. All three of these rangers with the Drow Aura, they'll slowly just begin. Well, Smell actually goes down.
Oh, didn't get level 6. One creep away and the Cold Snap plus the Dagger getting the kill. You know, I just assume with the ward there and knowing the P's in the neighborhood and being that close that he wouldn't get caught, but still ends up going down.
Yeah, just a little bit too greedy. Only one creep away, whether it's denied or not, from the level 6. So just hanging out a little bit too long, could have just backed up and gone to the hard camp. So kind of unfortunate and pretty costly dying like that. So whenever you're just one creep away from level 6, they, NP realizing that he wasn't 6 and trying to get something out of that before he does get to that crucial level. So nice rotation for 1437, hoping Sumail would get greedy, and he did. So
the universe moves back to the jungle now, already level 7 and 1,000 gold bank, so a very fast pace here for Vanguard, assuming he wants to go for that, or potentially a blink. And NP still holding onto the offensive tri lane. There has been a bit of ancient stacking as that ward expired. I think at least one of these was undoubtedly scouted by EG. And they're up against the Sven. They've certainly played the hero enough historically to know how he operates. Definitely have a lineup that can fight well around those ancient storm, being able to scout things out, the axe blink initiation a bit later on, and of course they can steal them with the axe, so he will need to guard those vigilantly. But for now, Sumail, he moves into the enemy neutrals. He now is going to trot down towards bottom, and for the time being, 1437, the man out in front playing very aggro on the top lane, but still a relatively quiet game. We really haven't seen that many rotations, just the one from the PA. The big ults are coming fairly soon. Warlock already 4 and change. The Slardar Blink Dagger not that far off as far as item progression goes. So I imagine we're going to see a lot more action relatively soon.
Yeah, EG not giving up any kills in this top lane is actually very impressive. Really nice positioning from the supports, especially versus all this disable they have in this MP tri lane. Is like, it's really, really important you don't die in lanes like this, because they do have the luxury of the pulls, so the supports, like you said, almost a level up on NP supports, and once they get these big ults online and the Axe Blink Dagger, they will have a super strong timing with the Drow, only one level away from level 6 as well, so their power spike gonna increase massively in just a couple of minutes with those items and levels.
Sumail posting up in the mid lane. Continues to shove it in and getting a little chip damage in on the tower whenever the creeps get to it. There will be a TP rotation. The first move from a core is going to be MSS. Turns towards top momentarily. Fire Observer Ward in the area, freshly planted down, and for now Sven the only hero showing, so they might get a glimpse of this. All about when that smoke breaks, and it breaks at a pretty decent time. Zai, though, still gonna get caught out here. The cast comes through. Oh, that crush hurts real bad, and they find the kill with the Sunstrike. That will secure the EE Midas. He gets the last hit. The experience as well, but Sumail immediately moves in on him. Sunstrike's on cooldown, so he can play much more aggressively here. Not gonna go for anything on his own.
A nice move from MSS, realizing that game is not going so great right now. The Warlock almost level 6 and trying to make the most out of that small timing they have before he's 6.
Universe does reveal the Blink, finds a solo kill bottom. Blink call into a dunk, chops up the PA who wanted to catch up a bit in levels here. Zesk also close to his own Blink, about 400 gold short, but Universe is going to get him out. Can he finish him off? The Crush retreating out. Shadow Ward won't be enough on its own, it looks like. Has the two stick charges even if he gets close. Unless Universe wants to blink again and doesn't want to risk getting caught and crushed under a tower. So he will make it out.
Cute little play there. Dropped his Tranquils right before the tower hit him, so able to keep the move speed up and the region, so he can top back off to full and maybe rotate mid off of that.
They're getting very aggressive now with this universe plague. And MP have actually abandoned the bottom lane entirely. Even though they see three heroes elsewhere, and they still have the tier 1, they just not want to tango with EG.
MSS going down there is actually really huge for EG. Was only like 200 gold away from his blink, just trying to head back to the lane and farm that up. And going down there, they're going to continue to pressure him. And Axe being off map, seeing him down here, MSS has to be really careful. If he goes down again, that'd be catastrophic for them, as MP really needs him to get that blink. Aoi is not doing the best in terms of net worth, so it's going to be a long time before he has that first saver blink. So really depending on MSS to get a pretty good trigger timing.
Oh, that blink call from Universe, though. Relocate coming in hot. Speaking about delaying the blink dagger, they're going to get him with the Shadow Wars. The Frost Arrow is not particularly high level, only 2, but it's enough for the first kill, and now they're going to snowball it into 2. A chop Universe. Here is it as they also bring down the Witch Doctor. EG, full on jungle invasion, well underway now. Mal even getting involved there, so 5 heroes bottom, basically, as the final one will crit TPing back down to rejoin the team as the relocate ends.
Yeah, super nice from EG realizing that, hey, if we can shut down the Slaughter's Blink Dagger, they really have no way to make moves time. Sven is quite poor, and the Evoker isn't going to have a very high impact for a long time, so going down there, getting that aggressive move, killing the Slaughter, and now getting this tower as well, so the Slaughter is going to have to sit up here and farm this top lane for a little bit. We'll have it in a few more waves, but EG going to have control of their jungle now, and the Drow Ranger and Wisp, really, really elusive once the Drow gets some items, because of the overcharge, you can just sort of power farm all the lanes, and it's very hard to get on top of this Drow.
Man, EG, they have a script to deal with Sven, don't they? Like, they warded off the Ancients multiple times now, or at least kept picking on them. Didn't contest that first Ancient stack, instead Tier 1, but they've also dropped some sentries here to block the smaller camps. They take down the Tier 1 bottom. Not only can they farm, but they, it looks like, have a plan that's hellbound on just denying NP any sort of comeback gold and turbo farming in their own right.
Yeah, the job porting at the top with the Universe, so continuing to just kill MSS really frightening.
Oh, good call from Universe. Another chop, another kill. Suddenly 4-1. Brit comes in from behind, just relocating himself in. Not anybody next to him, but it's enough for a follow-up kill. The rock is dropped, and then Envy all of a sudden might go down here. He's low to the Fatal Bonds. Looks like he should survive this with the 2 Quas Swords, but DG instantly transitioning back into a push. Crit unable to stay there.
Holy cow.
But... oh, Envy actually gets called down by Sumail on the backlines on top of that. So EG, made 3 kills. He did that while he was invis, right? So he just balled where he predicted him to be?
Yeah, that was blind.
And has no vision, yeah. Sumail just comes rushing in, like, from, I don't know, what, the top rune, roughly?
Yeah, it was around there. Kill. He was walking up the ramp to that hard camp area. Just zipped all the way over.
So you have Io just, like, spirit bombing them at the tower. Normally it's NP who'd think would be doing the spirit bombing. And then Sumail... little zipping of his own. So EG like that, take the tier 1, find another 3 kills. Suddenly Universe has a blade mail on top of this, and they're not done yet. They're going to immediately roll under the tier 1 mid. They are just styling on NP right now. Over a 5,000 gold lead at 13 minutes.
Yeah, EG just hitting all of their timings right on the head. Continuing to shut the Slaughter down. 3 deaths after, you know, he was this far away from Blink Dagger 5 minutes ago. Now, still not having the blink.
Oh, Universe, he's got the high ground position, he gets up the blink off! Speaking of that blink, it's gonna be delayed again. Blade mail ready to go. Envy almost got caught there as well. And maybe NP even lucky it wasn't him, but Universe straightly transitions on towards mid now after that. And they have their eyes set on this tier 1 mid, so access to the Ancients has become a problem. Universe there, getting the Battle Hunger out on Envy, but doesn't have much backup though. As I say that, they can always relocate in. They do have the Storm. Speaking of that Storm, Mail going for that more aggressive build. It will be an early Orchid. Not even going to bother with the Bloodstone for now.
Yeah, it's actually kind of surprising that he's going for that. Fallen quite a bit out of favor lately, as it does limit your farming quite a bit. But you can sort of tell how they want to play this game at this point, realizing how strong they are right now. And going for the items to help them fight right here, right now, trying to get a massive lead in this early game. And like you said before, they had a plan to deal with the Sven. You could see it earlier yesterday playing versus Complexity. They let them take the Drow, and then they picked Ogre and Nature's Prophet and just like aggro trialing them. And so you know, punishing their weaknesses. You can see EG really prepared for these games.
Uh-oh. Well, this could be bad for the Fen. He doesn't have access to Godfrey. The Kai'Sa comes out far too late. The Blade Mail Chomp just goes right through all that armor from the Warcry. They'll collect two kills here. Envy, well, he managed to TP out, and he's straight for Roshan, sight of some haunted recent memories, perhaps. But hopefully, with MSS here, it could be a better story for him this time around. Does have the double force here, so the alacrity, so they're gonna try to sneak Roche, but even if they get it, it's already EG just utterly wrecking it, dude.
Yeah, at this point, it's more of a just denying the Roshan. Doesn't really do that much on EE right now. Still not in fighting shape or even close to it, but getting out of the drow's hands slows down EG's death wall maybe a little bit and giving a nice boost of gold, so. That killing the Roshan, I think giving a last to MSS as well, so has the Blink Dagger now, so NP probably going to go look for a play as they are sort of in dire straits right now. Need to try and find some solo pickoffs of heroes alone and punish them before EG gets the rest of their core items and just groups up for a push.
Well, this one goes swimmingly, I guess you could say, for NP. At least there was no real test from EG. And it does, as you pointed out, deny it to the Storm, which would have been actually very game-breaking, but... Still, EG in great shape here. They have a fresh rock ready to go. They've got all their support levels and items to get them through this stage of the game. And only just now is the blink picked up on MSS. By the time that he gets his blink, Universe has not only a blink and a blade mail, but he's on his way to either Yule's or a Force Staff. So big items for the Axe, who is just now falling out of favor as far as the most farm in the game. But he was there for a while. So the Ancients begin to get farmed. Shadowblade will be picked up by the Draw Ranger. They really want to flex their map control muscle, EG do. Owie! Getting there. The Echo Saber under construction. The Blink Dagger reveals Sunstrike makes Dumail go splat. Big pickup there. And then the Centaur dominated creep is going to be microed beautifully as they try to bring down the Axe, but he will be brought back to the well. The IO might just be sacrificing itself for the greater good here. We'll have to see. No, they want to fight this. They got the Rock. Bring in Universe. He's already TP'd himself back to mid, but the IO gets caught and the rock gets dropped. Look for the call. It's on two. Blade Mail available as well. Will be activated, but Envy able to still hope the Aegis SVG most likely will be going down. Can they at least save the Invoker? That's the question. The Fatal Bond. Oh, it's going to crack the Aegis, and they're also going to get that kill to the north. And now on to Owie. Universe, he's got bloodlust in his eyes. Only seen red. The amp damage comes out from Slardar. Threatens to go deeper here. Just winding up the crush, and that game of chicken will end, but they get the Aegis, they get two kills, exchange for an IO and a Storm, but EG just straight into the push after that.
Yeah, that ward on the hill, Storm zipping up there trying to get vision and maybe start a fight, but didn't realize they had the ward there, got the crush into the Sunstrike with the cold snap, so I wasn't able to zip away before he had blown up. A nice kill on him, but afterwards, Arteezy coming out from the side, MSS not really timing, he crushed onto the relocate back perfectly, and so Arteezy getting the silence off, the Wisp able to live through and then heal everybody up after the Axe coming in with a nice call. So really well played from EG, realizing that they can turn this fight even though they're a hero down.
I mean, honestly, like, you see five heroes surrounding where a Wisp is coming back to and the Axe doesn't even directly return on the relocate, you're like, okay, they're at least gonna get crit here. But even crit lives for some time there with Zai dropping the rock. And well, How do you see the teams matching up going later, Quinn? Like, there is some obvious late game here on both sides, but for now, EG have all their outer towers, and it is a Sumail Storm on the Dire side, so with the Drow backing it up. Does either team have the edge? Is it more about execution here for you? And how do you see them stacking up?
I think a lot of it, like you said, does come down to initiation. NP, to win these fights, they really need to get the jump with either the Slaughter or the Sven. Maybe even jumping separate targets, so getting as many initial pickoffs as they can, because if these fights don't go very, very quickly, NP needs to win these fights in a super short amount of time, getting a crit with the PA, Sunstrike, because once they use all their initial spells, they really have no sustained damage in their lineup. It's all around bursting a couple of heroes, so if they don't get that initial jump, the Warlock heal, the Fatal Bonds, the Rock coming out, the Storm just chasing people down, the cold arrows, NP really needs to take these fast fights, and if they don't get initial kills, then EG, as the game goes later and later, just gonna dominate these fights that don't end in just, you know, 6-7 seconds.
especially when you, like, later on in the game, the Sven's getting repeatedly called, potentially, his BKB wears low. Slard are unlikely to live through extended fights, given that he's just a walking Blink Dagger crush and an amp damage at this point. So, we'll see. At that point, it really puts a lot of weight on Envy's shoulders to go over. And speaking of Envy, he did stop off our Staff of Wizardry here. Not go straight into the BOT's Blink build, and it's actually a completed Yule Scepter for him, so wants to be able to survive in the team fights and also to have a little more utility, but obviously will come at the cost of his pure farm. If there's a relocate onto Owie, ult the Gust, not canceling the TP, and he'll make it out just in the nick of time there. Universe getting into position. So they're going to find a free relocate kill on the comeback. It looks like Dust gets popped. They really want Arteezy, but no, they're gonna jump on a crit. He just gets blown up, and now the Golem's there. They thought it was an easy trap to be sprung, but it's actually an easy trap, and this is the one stringing it. Stormbolt's there, but two male kept alive for the time being by crit with the overcharge for Tether doing work. They isolate and will bring down the Sven. Now EG surging into the NP base. I mean, that just looked like a free IO, and it was anything but, and they're not even done yet. So get off the Casca Universe, but Arteezy Silver edging after them. He's striking distance. Just doesn't get off that first frost arrow. Blink away, but already they're going high ground.
Yeah, it was a really nice play from EG after the relocate gank whiffing. Everybody just immediately can see in the minimap making a beeline for the bottom lane. Smail with a haste rune as well, so not having to waste a lot of mana to step into the fight and having plenty to chase after the heroes and get the pull off onto the invoker.
Yeah, that's like the next, that's like uncovering like the second level of the IO relocate gang. It's like, well, we have to, you know, historically, like when teams started playing IO, like there was a period where they would just two-man relocate, like tiny IO, just backup kills. Then other teams started to get good at ambushing, and we saw it used more as a counter gank. And then when teams would use it, it would be with a setup hero, like an Axe Blink Call, or a Batrider Lasso to start things off. And this is that next level where you have a plan B in case it fails, or who knows, maybe even the EG do a relocate gank just to bait NP going after the IO when she comes back. So really big, peeling out that extra layer of the onion, I guess you'd say.
Yeah, I think that baiting aspect of it, that may have even been what they were going for there. Universe using the call really early on in the spend and having a TP out. So you could see right after he TP'd, they immediately knew what NP was going to do. And that's sort of been the story of this game so far. EG just one step ahead of them at every moment, realizing, you know, the timings they need, how they want to fight, and when they want to fight. And if you know what your team, what the other team is waiting for, you know, their strongest timings, if you understand the game at that level, then, you know, you can see the moves they're making, killing the Slaughter over and over again, delaying his blink, just ruining all their timings. And, you know, like we saw in the last fight, understanding as well they need to take these slow fights, not getting jumped by the Sven, just playing this game like perfectly, EG understanding exactly what they need to do.
NP playing checkers and EG perhaps four-dimensional chess. I don't think it's quite that bad, and a lot of this obviously is the snowball effect that they've had from a strong start to the game, but definitely pushing their advantage here. Four staff now complete on Universe. We can take stock of some of the item pickups. Sven already had the Echo Saber. And does grab the Blink Dagger as his next item, and with that, NP are going to smoke out of the base. No deep vision for EG in this neck of the woods, but at the same time, with all but one tower up, there's pretty limited options of where NP want to go unless they're just going to dive straight onto a tier 1 blindly. And already, you see the circle drawn here. It's correctly identifying that NP, well, I think he might have thought they were in the woods, and in fact, They're just coming, but they nail them with the scan. This could get ugly for EG. Don't really have anyone back behind them. Is there going to be a corresponding dire stand? They find that Blink Trust! The agent there! Surprise, motherfucker! And EG lose too, just like that. Holy shit. They were like, alright, we know they're smoking, we know they're in the woods. Surely we're safe behind this tower, but when they were wrong.
Wow, that was that scan absolutely perfect. That super deep ward between the trees, not in a common spot next to this tower here, and scouted them walking back up. So saw them going into that nook and then hitting them with the scan to make sure they didn't relocate or TP out, and getting a couple pickup kills. That's the kind of stuff that NP needs to get back in this game. So
meanwhile, Sumail, well, starting to go hard in the paint. They may have found two kills top and one on a trial, but just as quickly they'll lose Owie. Sunstrike. Oh, he gets the creep. Sumail, overall, getting out of control here. So Radiant Courier even got chopped. Universe cuts it off on... It's a bloody little mess on the way to the secret shop. Didn't have anything on it. So... Oh, actually... Excuse me, it had a single infused raindrop. So, the one lane of Rax down, EG finding their kills, and now just gonna transition straight into the mid lane. The whole squad together this time, and the rock is available for this high ground siege. This is gonna be hard for NP.
Yeah, Sumail having the bloods on the wall with those kills as well, so starting to rack up the charges up to 14, so even if he does die, gonna have the really quick respawn timers. He's only level 16, so not really long despite the bloodstone, so even if he does get burst down, he'll be able to TP back in after a short amount of time and continue this push of MP. If NP commit a lot of spells like the Sven ulti.
Well, Sumail arming out the enemy woods now, does have the two charges so far, and they will move back to Roshan, and this time around Envy won't get the free trades where, you know, he gives up a hero or two or maybe a tower, but at least he takes Rosh. Now this BG, they'll collect that Aegis for themselves as well, and that's going to give Storm a massive tower play coming into the next team fight.
Yeah, Sumail picking up the plate mail as well, so all their itemization is countering out this play that MP has, so they just have to burst a lot of heroes. Arteezy eating the Hurricane Pike very early on, as well as Silverage, so very tanky and super mobile, getting two mobility items as first two core items.
Take the Aegis, and they're a bit too late. Kefra's going for the Blink Call, gonna miss, but he just dives straight onto Envy. He gets stunned, focused, but that overcharge doing so much work to keep him alive. He goes in deeper, the crush comes through at the same time the Yule throws Sumail up into the air. Now he's stunned, still cooling down. This leaves a very sad and rather relatively immobile Witch Doctor on the back line, who's quickly dealt with. They do manage to bring down the IO as a trade. Envy goes in Viz, he sneaks out. And Sumail continues pursuit. There's the second drop. Welcome to Space Jam Episode 2. God, I wish they would make a sequel to that movie, but... Yeah. Three heroes down, Slardar hits the deck, and... Port PA really not having much of an impact. Make it four, Sumail will find Envy on the high ground. They had an off-century combo, and... That prompts a GG. He's like, Bloodstone Suicide, I'll die with you, Envy. It's okay, you gave us a good run for our money, but... EG still looking like Kings of the Castle here in North America, at least when it comes to more standard straight up Dota. Wow, that was pretty decisive.